Hello everyone, Sam is here from myfirestmagicweb.com. I'm making this video as part two of my subscription packet, the instructions video. The first video I made, and I showed you how to download, open the zip folder which you receive in the email, and then download all those EA indicator and all the stuff in there in proper folders. Now, once you have all of that, and when you apply those things, those indicators and everything, and up the template and on a 4-minute chart for IB setup, IB system, this is the chart supposed to look like. Okay, so how do we get to this point? In this video, I will go to show you exactly. So this is where you have all the indicators, the EA, you know, is all already downloaded, right? So now, what we need to do is from the scratch, I'll show you. I'll open the chart that I don't have right now, the pair, so that you can, I can open them and show you step by step what to do. Okay, this is the blank, you know, any, this is a profile, different profiles you have, like default, you have this, right? When you open a new brokerage or a new chart. So open a chart like that and then do all of these. What we need to do is these charts, these candlestick formation, MT4 does not allow. So we use an EA to get that. And for the EA to use, this is what we need to do. We need to open a 1-minute chart of any pair that you want to open. So for example, I have most of them open here, which I want. But let's say US CAD, we go for US Canada or something. US CAD would be fine, or USD franc. I don't have that open, so let's go with USD franc. Okay, so we open a chart, simple like that, and turn into a 1 minute. Okay, now make sure that auto scroll is off. Okay, and then what we need to do is that we hit the scroll, home button on your keypad, or just scroll down like that as far as possible it takes you. Okay, so for me, already have done it, I guess. It is just to collect more data on 1 minute chart, that's all. Okay, so I went as far back as March 31st, so April, and it's almost the end of May, so 2 months of data, that's fine. Okay, for 1 minute chart. So once we have that, right click and refresh. Okay, so we have this data saved on this chart. This chart, this 1 minute chart, will act as an host chart of the real chart we're going to open, and that will be offline. So I'm going to show it to you. Okay, so keep that this chart here, refresh, and then we're going to place the EA on this chart. So we're going to go up here, and we're going to get this EA for IB system in MT4, and we drag and drop here. You can also double click and it will come here. Once it is here, what you can do, what we need to do, is that go on this tab first. Okay, common, and make sure you have this enable, allow live trading enable. I don't know if it worked, what purpose, but I have it on and working, so that's what I'm going to tell you. Just keep it on, and make sure this allow DLL is always on. Okay, to do that, let me show you one more thing before we do that. Okay, once you have this broker open and this chart, right, then you go in tools and then option, and then when you have these, you go in charts and make sure that you have all of these checked, and here you just go and simply place 999999 all of them. Okay, and then you go expert advisor, and here make sure that you do allow automatic trading and allow DLL. Right, these two should be checked. Okay, so and after that, so that it will be automatically all the pairs you're going to be opening, the allow DLL will be already on. Okay, so now after doing that, you place the EA in here. Let's go and do that. See, now common, it's already checked here, 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 that's fine. And then we go in the input. And what we need to do is we need to open two charts. One is for 4 minutes and one is for 10 minutes, right? The minute those things are, I mean, the time in this system doesn't mean anything. Okay, Renko charts, Renko bars. You see Renko bar box size, that's what it means. That is the important thing. So we need to open one chart with 10 and one chart with 4 tick, right? So what I do basically to identify which one is which, I make the time frame as well as same as the tick, amount of the tick. So I'll change this one to 10 as well as the time frame. I'll make it, it doesn't make any difference, but I'll make it 10 so that I know that I'm on the 10 minute chart means 10 tick chart, right? So make it 10 and 10. And to show the wick or not to show the wick. The show wicks with the candles or not to show. So I would make it false and then press OK. So you will have the EA place here and then you see here a smiley face. That means it's working. Make sure that auto trading is on here. Okay, if it is off, then you'll see a cross sign. So make sure it is on. So right now, right after that, in few seconds, you will get this message. I just got it, right? So these charts are on, and now it says, it give you a message that open offline USD franc 10 minute to view chart, right? Okay. So what we do is we go there, here, in file, and then you see it's open offline. You click that. And then in a few seconds, you will have a list of the charts which are available. And we will look for, what we need to open is USD franc 10 minute chart. So we go all the way down for the USD franc, and here is M10, right? No, this is USD yen. Okay, USD franc is up there. And USD franc M10. So double click on that, the chart is open. All right. And now on this chart, we will place our template which we have here. Okay, magic IB template. We're gonna look for that. It should be an M magic IB system template, right? So I have it here different. It's like for 16 minute and 6 minute, which I usually open on other broker just to see what the market is opening. But you don't really need to do that. I need to do it because I need to teach, right? A lot of things. So we're gonna open 10 and 4, and you use this for that. So magic IV system template, you apply that, and boom, you have the chart look like this. Okay, one thing is missing here, which I don't usually do it, but I gave it to you, and which is the range indicator. I don't have it because it takes a lot of space, but you should all have it on, because that it will tell you whichever pair you're trading, you keep it on. Like this one, this is where it is, range trader. It is the part of the packet, so you place that, and what happens that what you get, don't do anything on this one, it's just turn it on, press OK. So see all this information coming in, and what is important is the information about the range. See average 60 day range 126, previous day range 170, and current day range 45. What is the range? The range is the daily open, from the daily open, the daily high to daily low, how much the pair travel in a particular day. So what you can do is that if you have a daily open line, which also I gave you the indicator, right, this white dotted line here, this is the day open here, right? So the highest point to the lowest point is the daily range. So previous day range, for example, this day range, so up until here, so this was the highest point, right? And the day started here, so this is the lowest point, this candle, right? So this is the lowest point, this is the highest point. You find out how many pips, and that is the range. That's the daily range. Usually pair, if you have that, you know that this pair average travels 126 pair. So let's say if you find a setup here, and you start counting from top to bottom, you only travel 40 pips. So if you have a setup and you think that it's going to go up, it need to go above this high to finish up the range, because from this low to the highest point would be 126 or 130 pip area, right? So if you only travel 40 and you're going up, then you need to go all the way up to close, to get close to that average daily range, and that usually is the target. Okay, and then pair does that most of the time. Today is a Memorial Day. Everybody is off. All the banks are closed, Europe and America. So what we have is a very, very low volume. The price not moving, and it will not move today. There is no volume at all. So that's why we have it 45. So it's unusual, but usually average range for this pair is 126. Right? So this is how you get these charts. So this one we open for a 4 minute chart, right? And you can even see here, no, sorry, this is a 10 minute chart, M10, USD franc, M10, right? So all set and done for that. Now we go back and open a 4 minute chart here, USD franc. We're gonna open a host chart first. 1 minute, auto scrolling off, and then hit the home button on the keyboard. Get to as far as back in, as possible, March 31st I got, and then refresh the chart to save the data and place the ear on this chart. Okay, make sure this common, just to make sure these four boxes are checked. Input, now we gonna place here 4 and 4. Okay, and VIX off, you can keep it on. Let me show you what happens when you keep it on, so that way whichever way you feel good, you can do it. Doesn't really matter. Okay, it's a message. We wait for the message. It comes when the tick comes. Okay, without the tick, it doesn't run. So as soon as the first tick comes in, the message comes. The offline chart empty, M4 now, right? We need to open an M4 chart. So we go up here and we open an offline chart. List is there. USD franc M4 we need, and USD franc M4 is here. Double click on that. You open a chart, and then you go and apply the template for Magic IV system template. And now you have USD franc M4 chart open as well. Okay, so now what I do is this 10 minute chart move here, 4 minute chart move here, and these host chart, let them sit here. And you can do is, what you can do is open your daily or weekly chart or monthly chart for SNR levels, regular chart also in that area, and leave it there just for a reference or high and lows. So what I do is this simply chart, and if I have the template for it in this broker, I don't know, I'm gonna see what happened here. Okay, let's see if I have anything on USD franc, the UF here, any template from previous, which I don't. So what I'll use, just my regular template like this one, and just to see, you know, how it is working and where are. So what I do is, this is what I teach. You know, you will get to learn every single thing, believe me. Just I'm showing in this video just how to open those charts. Okay, these charts up and running, and these highs and lows, the weekly chart, so you mark them, or you can draw the line, whichever is coming in, like this one. This is important, very close by, big level here, right? So we want to see if the price get to that area, what will happen. And then the second one is right there to the upside. This is to the downside, this is to the upside. Price is in between, so we're gonna see if it get to this point, then what will happen. If it start dropping, we will go immediately and look for the setup cell. Okay. For example, let's say weekly chart. Where did we bounce from, for example? Okay. So you can clearly see that from here, this was the low, right? These are the low areas. So if you mark, for example, like this one, this is the low of 90.21. What you can do is, on a 4 hour, 90.41, right? So 90.41 we go and we look for 90.41, and we see if we get there and what happened. 90.41 is right here, right? And now there is another one just above this one. It's a little bit higher, right? This is the low of 90.89. Okay, so again we go on a 10 minute and put 90.89 as well. So you have a little range of 90.89. Okay, now, all right, So now you have this range that you expect that the price will drop, and then you see what will happen. Okay. So 10-minute chart and then analysis chart, which I give you usually, analysis chart. Don't worry about that. I'll be guiding you and teaching you as well. And you will learn and do it on your own in no time. So see that the trick is it's coming down here, and then it gives you hit this level, and then it start giving you a bullish setup. So you could have taken this one, 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 you could have taken this one. All of these are long sell because we know that the price dropped here and then it may bounce. So if you have the line drawn here as well, for example, like this little band, and then you watch, you see how nice and easy and clean it is. That the price comes here when it is coming on a 1 hour chart. Even you can open a 1 hour chart as well. Simple, just to, you know, learn to clarify things. You see an hourly chart, and you place this template. If you want this template, I'll give it to you. Just email me. Oops. All right, so again here, 1989, right? 1989 is where the line have that area. You see 1989, this is it. So exactly here you can see this beautiful reversal, bullish reversal candlestick formation as well. Okay, it is a morning star here, the black candle, the star, and the big bullish white candle, and it tells you screaming that I'm going up now. Okay, and we bounced from the same area before. We're gonna bounce from here as well. And then you immediately you see the 10 minute, actually 10 minute is for the guidance. So once you see this here, this is May 14. You look for entries on 4 minute chart, May 14, which is way behind. So we're gonna get to that and see what time is it. May 14, we came close here, for example here, May 14, 10 o'clock, which is London Open. Okay, so we're gonna see 10:14 at London Open time. That is the key time for our trading, by the way. Okay, 8, 9, 11, oh, right around here. Okay, so this is what it is. This is May 18, May 8, man. I gotta go May 14. All right, so May 14 again on even this one, you mark 9089 where it is. There it is. Okay, so you see exactly here, and then these are the setup. What is the setup? Okay, the setup is that any SNR level you're bouncing, it's a turning point. As a turning point, you got two type of setups. One is with the continuation, wherever the trend is going right now, it's not bouncing, it already bounced or got rejected from resistance and dropping. So that is the continuation. That if you find something and you want to trade as a continuation, I'll tell you that later. But this is once you get to either a support or a resistance and making a turn. Okay. So then it is not important that if you are above the wave or below the wave. So when you're making a turn, usually you are the opposite side of the wave. So now here you're dropping and you're bouncing from here. That is bullish, and we need to go long. And even though we are below the wave, we will take these setups. This one, this one, this one, this one. See, the setup is that you have, if you have the wicks on, then you will see that red candles, red, 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 then a candle with the wick. If you have the wick off in the EA, then you will see this IB. IB means inside bar, which is like this bar would be IB to this, because the high is lower high than the previous candle. And the low is the higher low than the previous candle. Means the current candle is completely within the previous candle. That is inside bar, which is the inside of the previous candle. Okay. If you have this wick on, then you will see these wicks here. Okay. So either you get, if you have a wick on, then you will see a candle with the wick. If not, then you see an IB and then a bullet, the reversal opposite color candle. That is the setup complete. Giving this indicator is all the way down, turning to the upside. You see, he came all the way down, turning to the upside. You have a red candle, wick, blue. That is a setup. Okay, this is a setup. Red candle, IB, bullish candle, indicator came all the way down and going up. Right? That is a setup. This is again, indicator came below this line, this red line, a lower level, and then going up. You have a red candle, wick, blue candle, That's a setup. And this one, it's a setup, but the indicator is not completely down. So these were the good one. This one, and this one as well. Okay. This one is like when you're dropping big time, this was the first one. So it is on a 4-minute chart. It's a little risky. But once you see that, okay, the price went up and then came down and made the higher low while the indicator is all the way down, giving you a signal for the setup. That is a clear sign that, yes, we are making a turn from this support. And then you can take this one. Again, this one is higher low. Take this one. Again, this one is higher low. Take this one. You know, so whatever the amount of people. Even if you take this one, that's the middle one. It is 91.02. And even if you go all the way up here, like say the daily open for that day was here, and it works as a support and resistance, right? So it is 91.58, 59, 60, 62. So 91.02, 91.62, 60 pip. From here to here. Simple as that. Very easy. Again, when it comes back down here, it says, you take this one, look what happened. Okay? From here, what is the number? 91.32, and it went above the daily open. Obviously, it is going above the daily open. I don't know which day is that. Is it right or wrong? But maybe this was that day, or this was that day. No, this is the next day, right? This is this day ends here. Then the next day open up, and it bounced from here, and then it goes above the daily open, the day open. Then simply use the, if you don't know anything else at this point, you will learn everything in my webinars. But let's say if you're just starting, you don't know what it is, how to find the target, then you use simply the pivot points. Okay. These are the pivot points. So whatever the next pivot is to the high, make that target. 30 pip, 40 pip, 60, 70 pip above. Sometimes that the R1 gets broken and then we go straight to R2, especially if it is a London session or US session that the move starts like that. All right. So look what happened here is the number was 91.30 and we went up to 92.40. That's 100 pip run from here to here without any problem. Simple setup, right at the daily open, right above the, you know, just below. It's like mixing, you know, touching, messing around with the wave and then going above it. Right? All right. And usually you will find some kind of news that generate these moves. All right. News is, you can find on Bloomberg, economic calendar. Keep open either Bloomberg or Forex Factory or somewhere. There are a lot of places you will find those economic calendar, and watch out, have it on your cell phone app that gives you a sound alert, right? Whenever the news comes in, and then you have a boom, you know, you're on the cell phone, and then you all immediately start watching which, if the prices are moving on the board, across the board. So if the prices start jumping around, right around the news, you know that something is, you know, moving. Or have moved the market, and you look for your setup and get in and get out. So this is what the setup, this is how to make the charts, and this is how to look for the setup. Only the thing is that make sure that you are in the direction of the trend and in the direction of the 10-minute chart. For example, 10-minute is coming down here and there is no support, a big number, don't try to go long, even if the 4-minute gives you the long, because you are coming down. As long as these are red candles, okay, now once it hit this here, this area, you can see that now the indicator is down and then it's going up again. You have an IB here. This is a sign that if you have an IB on a resistance, an IB on a support, and then you go on a 4-minute chart and exactly see right here, it is 514, 13, almost 1400 hour, right? You have this IB here. So if you go on a 4-minute chart, and we look for 1400, which is right here, right? 13 and 14, you have this setup, this setup, this setup. So obviously, after the confirmation of the 10-minute that it is giving you an IB on 10-minute chart at the support, and after that, in 4-minute, you're starting to see higher lows and giving you the bullish setup. That's all there is to confirm that yes, we are bouncing from here and you are getting entries, and you just start taking it. Obviously, it's not going to all the way, you know, Elliott wave. I'll teach you that this is wave one, then it retraces a little bit for wave two, then it goes for big wave three, or if it is ABC, whatever it is, you just have to find out that which way. It is like a map. You're going from Miami to Orlando, and how far you have to take 95, then you have to get off from 95 and then go, you know, certain road, and then you have to take the turnpike and then go all the way to Orlando, right? Similarly, you know, in this, that, you know, it doesn't go on a straight line, 200, 300 pip. It makes Elliott waves, a small resistance, then it drops back to support, some kind of support, and then it starts going up. So you need to know a little bit of that so that you can take proper entries at the proper time. Okay. And that is also, after giving you all that, these are the major tools, but I also need to teach you how to use those tools, right? If I give you something very, very sophisticated computer and not teach you or give you a, you know, guide, you know, like a booklet or something that guides you how to use those tools, or the new cell phone, you don't know what to do with it, right? You need a guideline or a small booklet with it that tells you, okay, you know, you need to do this, you need to do that, you set up this, you set up that, and then you can use that tool properly with full potential. So this is a very, very great tool. Believe me, it is one of the top tool in the market right now. Okay. But the thing is, if I give you the very, very beautiful, sharp, the best of the best knife, and if I don't teach you how to, you know, cut the meat or the vegetable properly, you may cut your finger. Or even, you know, you can go and kill someone with that if you get angry or something. So the tool can be very useful, but at the same time can be dangerous if used dangerously or in a wrong way. Okay, so we need to learn how to use this properly. So I showed you what to how to set up the chart and how to use this tool, what is the setup and look like. Then there are a few factors that you will be learning in my webinars, of course. That, you know, what are the proper timings, what are the set, which pair moves when, how, and the news, how it affects. And you can just go start watching my previous webinars, and you will learn a lot of things from there. And by the way, they are on my website. You go here. This is not the website. The website is this one. And on the top of the website, you have webinars. You go in a previous recorded webinar, subscriber only. When you click that, the page will open and ask for a password. You put the password, you will be given a password. So you already have the password, right? So you use that password and you'll see all these previous webinar recordings where I analyze, do my analysis live, show everybody how I do it, what need to be done, what pair is doing what, and as well as teach the harmonic patterns, Elliott wave and all that. So you will learn. The key is the learning, right? So take advantage of these and learn as fast as possible. And then in probably in few months, you won't even need me, right? And you will be doing perfectly fine on your own. And this is it. This is it for now. And let's get started. Start setting up your charts and start watching my webinars. And soon you will be getting my invitation for upcoming live webinar. And then just, you know, make sure you attend it. Even if for some reason, if you can't attend my webinars, you will always get the recording later on. Once I do finish the webinar, then I convert the recording and then upload on the YouTube and privately. And then I'll send you the link so only the subscriber can see those. And then I upload that also on my website. So if you miss even that in your email, then you can always go and see on my website. It should be there. Okay, so this is it for now. Let's get started. Start setting up your charts and get ready. Okay, all right. So thanks for watching this video, and I'll be talking to you very, very soon. Bye now.